Hi, I'm James from Portainer, and in this video I'm going to talk about the new features in version 2.16 of Portainer. This release is focused around improving some of the existing capabilities of Portainer, in particular improvements to the way we handle ingresses in Kubernetes clusters, as well as the new Git credential support and the notification log. I'll cover the added ability to run remote commands on async edge devices, uploading local files when building images, and our standardizing of our logging. I'll also talk about the added Kubernetes secret types, shared memory size support, and some other quality of life changes, like adding text to the login screen and context-sensitive help. And of course, I'll tell you how you can upgrade to 2.16. Ingresses in Kubernetes can be complicated to set up, especially when you consider the different types of ingresses available. In version 2.16 of Portainer, we've done a lot of work around our ingress support, adding auto-detection of ingress controllers, support for types other than Nginx and traffic, as well as support for TLS. We've also moved the setting of hostnames and annotations out of the namespace level, making it easier to configure and manage these for IT admins. If you're deploying your applications from private Git repositories, you might have found it frustrating to have to enter your credentials for each stack or app you deploy. In 2.16, we've added a Git Credential Manager, letting you save credentials and use them when adding deployments. These creds are only available to the user that added them, so there's no issues with other users having access to your creds. Sometimes when you do things like deploy a container or make a config change in Portainer, you'll get a notification pop up in the top right corner. In case you missed the notification, or you want to go back and see the notifications you've had, we've now added a notification log in Portainer Business Edition. You can either select notifications from the left-hand menu, or click the bell icon in the top right of any page to see the log. When you're running your edge devices in async mode, before now you haven't had the ability to run remote commands on the individual devices. In 2.16, we've added this functionality, letting you browse your device as well as run commands like start, stop, restart, and delete on your containers, stacks, and volumes. When you're building a new container image, sometimes you might need to include custom files, such as a config file. When building from a Git repository or a tar file, you can just include that file along with it. But if you're writing the Docker file directly in Portainer, you haven't had the option before. In 2.16, we've added the ability to upload local files to use in your image builds. Just click the Select Files button in the Upload section to add your files, then you can reference them in your Docker file. We've made some changes to how we do logging in Portainer in 2.16. In this version, we've moved to using the zero log standard for Portainer's logs as part of larger standardization work we're doing. For the most part, this won't affect you much, but this should make it easier to identify issues with your installation. We've expanded the types of secrets that can be created through Portainer in version 2.16. Before now, we only supported the opaque secret type, but we've now got support for the built-in secret types, as well as the ability to create your own custom type. When you're creating a secret, simply choose the type from the drop-down menu. In 2.16, we've added the ability to define the shared memory size for individual Docker containers through the Portainer UI. You can set this through the Advanced Container Settings section when creating or editing a container. When you're using Portainer in a larger organization, you might have a requirement to display a message to all users at the login screen before they log in. In 2.16, we've added a field to let admins set this message through the Portainer UI. On each page of the Portainer UI, you'll find a question mark icon in the top right. In 2.16, clicking on this icon will take you to the documentation for the page you're currently on, making it easier to find the answers you're looking for. This is the first step of improvements we're making to our in-app documentation, so look out for more of this in future releases. These are the big features and changes in 2.16, but there's also a lot more other changes and fixes in this release. Have a look at our release notes for the full list of changes. If you're doing a fresh install of Portainer on your environment, Business Edition users can take a look at our install guide at install.portainer.io. This will guide you through what you need to run Portainer and show you how to install it. For our Community Edition, you can use our documentation at docs.portainer.io. upgrade guides for both editions are also available in our documentation, as well as instructions for upgrading from CE to BE. Thanks for watching. I hope I've been able to show you some of the new features and updates in Portainer 2.16. If you do have any questions, need help, or would like more information on anything I've talked about here, please check out our documentation, join our community support channels, or get in touch with us directly.